Shankaram, Shankaram, Loka Shankaram, Shankaram, Shankaracharyam, Keshavam Badarayanam, Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande, Bhagavantau Punah Punah, Ishvaro Guru Ratmere, Murti Veda Vibhagine, Vyumavad Vyapta Dehaya, Dakshina Murtaye Namah, Om Ityeta Dakshara Mudgita Mupasita, Om Ityeshudgayate, Tasyopavyakhyanam. Sadeva Soumya Idamagra Asir Ekameva Advitiyam Taddhaike Ahuhu Asadeva Yasadeva Idamagra Asir Ekameva Advitiyam Tasmat Asatah Sajjayata. Taddheke Ahuhu. Tanha Eke Ahuhu. With reference to that, some say, the Vainashika say, Asadva Idamagrasit Ekameva Dvitiyam. That this universe before its creation was Asat. Non-existence, ekameva dvitiyam, without a second. Tasmad asatah sajjayata ajayata, from that asat, non-existence, the existence, creation, was born. Subhashakar tadetu viparita grahanam, asadva idamagrasit ekameva dvitiyam, that this is all non-existence makes no sense at all, because these words do not convey any sense at all. And so even this sentence also would not convey a sense that all of this was non-existent, because it has no form. If akara of the shabda is a meaning, it doesn't have a form and therefore doesn't convey any meaning. So Vashyakara said the words, the sentence we interpreted as sadeva summa idamagrasit itina, that all this was existence is not so. Tasmad asatah sajjayata, satah sajjayata itina, from the existence, existent thing came, is not so. This is how the sentence should be interpreted. Tadetad viparita grahanam mahavainashikapam darshayitva pratishedati. Having first shown this viparita grahanam, this wrong conclusion, wrong perception, the part of the vainashikas, part of this nihilists or the shunyavadins, pratishedati, the Shruti herself, Uddalaka himself in fact, dismisses or refutes that idea. So second parasite said, kutasthukalu soumya idam syat iti hovacha katham asatah sajjayate iti satveva soumya idamagra asir ekameva dvitiyam. Kudastu khalu soumya evam saad. He soumya, oh good looking one, how can that be so? That asatah sajjayate iti kutastu syat, why kutah, so kutaschit pramanat evam na sambhavati, by no means of knowledge available to us, the perception, inference, even the shabda scriptures, nowhere this can be established that existent thing can be born of non-existence, how can that be? So what's the proof? What is the evidence in the statement? Then Vasikara gave the standard example. What do they say? Yadapi bijopamarde ankuro jayamano dustaha. They said that look, when ankura, the sprout, is born, then the seed is destroyed. So from the destroyed seed, a sprout is born. So from the destruction, from the non-existence, the sprout is born, is an example. How sprout, an existent thing, is born of non-existence. Because seed is no more there. So the seed is destroyed, and from destroyed seed, from destruction, from non-existence, the sprout has come. This is an example. So we are asking, what is the proof? What is the evidence? What is the drishtanta to show that existent thing emerges or is born of non-existence? So look, this is an example. That when you sow a seed, the seed is destroyed and then the sprout is born. Tadapi abhyupagam viruddham tesham. Even this statement of their itself will contradict their own principle. This statement that the sprout is born of non-existence, non-existent seed, it would contradict their own statement, their own assumption. How? Katam? Yetavat bija avayavaha bija samsthana visishtaha te ankurepi anuvartanteva na tesham upamardaha ankura janmane. Now about the seed, there are two aspects. One is the particles of which the seed is made, other is the form or the shape of the seed. So all these particles are arranged in a certain configuration. All the particles of seed are arranged in a certain configuration, which is what we call a seed. Like in case of pot also, all the grains of the clay are arranged in a certain configuration, which is what we call a pot. So this pot also has two aspects. One is the particles of clay of which it is made, and second is the form in which, you know, the particles have arranged themselves, the configuration. Of this, Mahashakara says that bija avayavaha, the particles consisting of the seed, the particles that make up the seed are very much found in the sprout also. So bija avayavaha, bija samastha, meaning that bija avayavaha, those particles are not destroyed. When you say that the seed is destroyed, what do you mean? What do you mean when you say that the seed is destroyed? Are you saying that the particles which make up the seed, the particles are destroyed, or the form, the shape of the seed is destroyed? Now when you come to particles, then the particles are not destroyed because we find that the particles are present even in the sprout also. So when you say seed is destroyed, you do not mean particles, because particles are very much sustained, very much there. Anuvartante, they continue to remain in the sprout. Na tesham upamardaha ankurajanmani. Therefore, certainly you cannot say that the particles are destroyed when the seed is born. Then what else is destroyed? You mean the form is destroyed? Yat punaha bijakara samsthanam tad bija avaya vyatirekena vastubhutam na vainashikai abhyupagamyate. The vainashikas, the shunyavadin, say that the shape is not a reality, it's not a thing, substance. The form of the pot is not a vastu. There is no such real thing, or there is no such entity as a form. The only entity are the particles making of the form. The form, or the shape, or the configuration doesn't have any substantiality. Therefore, they do not accept that as a vastu. The vastu bhutam vainashikai abhivagamyate. So it is true that the shape is destroyed. The shape of the seed is no more there. So if you say that the shape is the seed, or the configuration of particles is the seed, then that gets destroyed. But that configuration is not accepted as an entity by them. Therefore, what is not there cannot be destroyed. According to them, all there is are the particles of seed. They don't accept the shape, the form, the configuration as any reality. It's not there. So what is the question of destruction of what is not there? So nothing is destroyed really. Asa tat avayavitektam vastubhutam tathāca sati abhyupagam virodah. You say that there is no, we accept the form also as an entity, then that will contradict your own principle that the form doesn't have any reality at all. Meaning form does not stand apart, we know that. The form does not stand apart from particles. The form of the pot, for example, does not stand apart from the particles of the earth which make up this pot. So it is true that form doesn't have any substance. So destruction of form is not the destruction of anything because it doesn't, So if you say that destruction of form is a destruction of seed, then that will contradict your own principle. Atha samrutya abhivagatam bijasamsthana rupam upamrudyate. Samruti means what? This common usage, what people think. But people think that there is a form here. People think that it's a real thing. People, because of their ignorance, give reality also to the shape or the form. So according to people, the pot is different and the clay is different. Because what is pot? Clay plus a name and form. Therefore, as far as people are concerned, the common understanding is concerned, there is also this form. Then therefore, even though the real form is not really there, people think it is there, from that standpoint, a so-called form gets destroyed. How about that? Something is destroyed. So we are asking, ka iyam samvrutir nama? What do you mean by samvruti? So we said, so samvrutihi brahmaha vastudatva akarakatvadi tesham vyavaharaha tas avaratakat vastudatva avaratakatvad. Samvruti means brahma, a delusion, because it veils the true nature of the thing. So what is this samvruti? Whatever it is. Kim asam abhavaha utabhavaha. You say that from samvruti, this samvruti, so the form of the seed which is accepted as samvruti is destroyed. Alright. So what is samvruti? Is it abhava or bhava? Is it non-existence or existence? Yadi abhava, drishtanta abhava. If samvruti is non-existence, then there is no drishtanta. We are discussing drishtanta, understand? Their drishtanta or their illustration of existence being created of non-existence is a seed. That is not yet established. So example of the creation of existence from non-existence is not established yet. Therefore, if you say that samruti is abhava, non-existence, then there is no drishtanta to establish the creation of an existent entity from non-existence. Atha bhavaha, if samruti is bhavaha, if samruti is an existent thing, then only from existent thing has come. Tathapi na bhavat ankurotpattihi. If samruti is bhava or existent entity, then it is not an example of creation of existent from non-existence. Therefore, that position remains, that where is kutastu khalu somya idam syat, evam syat. E somya, by what means of knowledge? By what example do you say? Where do you experience the creation of existent thing from non-existence? Where do you experience? So he gave the example. We experience it. Where? See, the seed gets destroyed and the sprout is born. So that example is being discussed, understand? You have not accepted that example. We are in fact refuting that very example itself. So if Dashtanta itself is disputed, then the Pratignya cannot be proven. What is Pratignya? Asataha sajjayate ajayate. From non-existence, the existent thing is born. Why? So what's the example? So bija become bijankurai vata. Like the ankura is created from non-existency. But that example is disputed. So drishtanta abhava. And we say that samvruti is bhava rupa existence, then that's what we are saying. From existence alone, an existent entity can come. From an existent entity, an existent thing can come. Something can be born of something. Something cannot be born of nothing. Therefore, bija avayavebhyai ankurotpattihi. Then what we say stands. We said that the seed is born of the particles of the sprout is born of the particles of seed. That position remains. They could not refute it. Now we are on page 222. The line number 4, Bhashyakara says, avayavaha ape upamrudyante iti ched. So they say that no, even avayavaha, even the particles of the seed, they get destroyed. So we are saying that we find anvaya, we find continuity of the particles of seed into sprout. They say no, the particles also get destroyed. Avayavaha api. Not only the shape of the seed gets destroyed, but even the particles also get destroyed. Iti chet. Suppose that is the position. In that case, the example will be alright. Bijankura example will work. If the avayavas, the particles are destroyed. Then Vashyakara says, na. Tat avayaveshu tulyatvar. Alright. So you say that a particle of the seed is destroyed. What is the particle? A particle also is an assembly of other particles in a certain configuration. If seed consists of 10,000 particles, and each particle also is small, no doubt. It has its own form and it also is made up of a number of other small particles. Because every assembly, everything is an assembly of its components, avayavaha. If seed is an assembly of the components called the particles, then particle also is an assembly of smaller particles. Because the particle is not a fundamental substance. Whatever is fundamental substance, like God's particle, that is a fundamental substance, if there is such an entity. We don't accept there is an entity like that. That's also a delusion. It's a universal delusion, right now. Then after 10, 15, 25, 100 years, whatever, somebody else will come with a different delusion, that's all. That is dismissing another delusion. But anyway, therefore, na tat avayaveshu tulyatvat tat avayaveshu. How about the avayava, the particles of the particles? So when you say that a particle is destroyed, what is destroyed? Is the shape of the particle destroyed, or the particles making of the particles, are they destroyed? Same rule will apply. So whatever actually applies to a seed also applies to its particle. So brilliant article, argument. So if you look at the Tika, line 35, avayava samsthanasyapi bija samsthanavat asatva avisheshat avayava samsthanasyapi. Avayava means a particle that also has a bhi-samsthanam, but that also has a configuration, that also has a shape, and also made up of its own avayava, its own particles. So bija-samsthanam asatva avisheshat. If the form of the seed is not an existent entity, then form of the particle also is not an existent entity. Tat upamardopi na sambhavati. Therefore, where is the question of destruction of a non-existent entity? That's not an example. Evam mula avayava paryantam avayavina abhavat. Now, that particle is made up of a number of other particles. Even that small particle has its own avayava, that particles. Even that particle also has its own avayava. Evam mula avayava paryantam. Like that, if you keep on subdividing until you come to mula avayava, the fundamental particles, indestructible particles, suppose, then that remains. Somewhere you will accept. If you accept a particle, then particle is the particle and ultimately you come to what? Mula avayava, the fundamental particle. So that is indestructible, that is not destroyed. So that is Sat, from which the Sat Biyankura comes. Avayavina abhavat tadumardasya nahetutvam. Avayavi, the configuration is not accepted, and therefore ultimately you come to the most fundamental particle. Kintu mula avayavanameva sarvatra tattat akarena avasthanamiti. So whatever is the mula avayava, whatever is the most fundamental component of a seed, smaller than the smallest, which you cannot subdivide further, suppose. Like the Vaisheshika say that atom is the most fundamental particle which cannot be further subdivided, indivisible. If everything is divisible, then you can never arrive at the fundamental thing, understand? Because you'll be able to divide it and divide and you'll never come to a fundamental. That's what science is finding out, you know. They keep on dividing further, the quark, whatever particle, then they are further dividing it, splitting it and splitting it. So ultimately everything reduces to what? That is what the Vainashikas say, that it all reduces to non-existence. We say it all reduces to existence. The form reduces to formless. Avayava samsthanam, that this has a samsthanam, has a form or a configuration. If you keep on subdividing it, ultimately it reduces to formless, not non-existence. They say that it reduces to non-existence. We say that it reduces to formless, which is existence. There's a big deal, big difference. Kintu mula avayavanamaiva sarvatra tattat akarena avasthanam. So whatever is mula avayava, whatever is fundamental particle, that makes up the next particle. Assembly of that makes up next particle, assembly of that makes up next particle, ultimately a seed, you know, is also an assembly. Therefore, abhavad utpatya na abhavad utpatti drishta. Therefore, we do not see utpatti or creation abhava from non-existence. We don't see. There is no example, drishta and abhava. That's a very important thing, because you make all kinds of principles in your mind, and then it cannot relate to the life, there's no point. There's no point in any scientific discovery which has no relationship to life. There's no point in any siddhanta or any philosophy which does not explain life, which does not relate to life. So where did you arrive at this idea that thing reduces to non-existence? or from non-existence something is created, where do you arrive at that idea? Where do you see it? Because for you to arrive at a principle, somewhere you must have experienced it. I've seen it. I've experienced it. Then alone, then all. So different acharyas come with different explanations. The same Upanishad also. So whether Advaita, Vishishta Advaita, Dvaita, but all of these are experience. It is their experience which has been theorized, which has been made into a principle, you know, system. So similarly, is there somebody who has experienced non-existence? If somebody has experienced non-existence, then that somebody is existent anyway. To experience non-existence, you must be present, you must be existent. Therefore, there is no total non-existence anyway. So Vashyagana says, यथा वैनाशिकानां बीज संस्थान रूपः अवयवी नास्ते तथा तत् अवयवाः अपि इति तेषामपि उपमर्द अनुपपत्तिः. यथा वैनाशिकानां वी संस्थान रूपः अवयवी नास्ति. अवयव इज देयर, अवयवी इज नॉट देयर. हू इज व्हाट इज अवयवी? अवयवी इज द वन पोजेसिंग अवयवास. सो फॉर एग्जांपल द पार्टिकल्स आर अवयव एंड दैट विच इज मेड ऑफ द पार्टिकल इज कॉल्ड अवयवी. सो अवयवी दे डोंट एक्सेप्ट. Avayava they accept. Therefore, nasti tat avayavaha tesampi upamarda anupattihi. So every avayava also is an avayavi. That also will not be accepted. Continuing, Vashyagana explains, bija avayava namapi सूक्ष्म अवयवाः तत् अवयवानामपि अन्ये सूक्ष्मतर अवयवाः इत्येवं प्रसंगस्य अनिवृत्तेः सर्वत्र उपमर्द अनुपत्तिः. Bija avayavanamapi sukshma avayavaha. As we said, that the particles comprising of the seed also have their own particles. So that is called a creation. That the small things assemble, assembly is creation. That further assembles. That's how Vaisheshika explained. There is a dvanuk and tranuk. So two atoms combine, that's called a dvanuk, and three dvanuk combines, that's called a tranuk. So it's the most fundamental thing, combining to make up the whole universe. So then tad avayana api anye sukshmatar avayavaha iti. Then that particle also has yet further finer particles as its constituents. Iti evam prasangasya anivruttehe. This way the process is endless. Subdivision process does not conclude anywhere. Therefore, sarvatra, so the seed is not destroyed. Because in seed, the form is not an entity, and the particle remains, so seed is not destroyed. Same will apply to avayava also, is consisting of particles having configuration, and that goes all the way. Therefore, sarvatra upamarda anupattihi, everywhere the destruction is untenable, is not logical, not in keeping with the reason. Am વાત થોડોક મોટો કરો પડશે એવું લાગે છે. Then says the Tikagara, Asataha sadutpattehe pramana abhavat asambhavaschetarhi sataha sadutpatti anupattihi pramana abhavat evityashankya sadbuddhi anuvritti avagata sattva anuvritti eva tatra pramana mityaha asataha sadutpattehe pramana abhavat. Okay, that there is no pramanam, no example to establish the creation of an existent entity from non-existence, because that example has been refuted. So there is no pramanam, no perception, no inference. Any perception is not there, no other pramanam can be there. Then tarhi satopi sat utpatti anupatti pramana abhavat. Then the Vainashika says, okay fellows, Vedantin, you say that something is born of something, an existent entity is born of an existent thing. Where is the proof of that? Where do you find that? Iti asankya sadbuddhi anuvritti avagata sattva anuvritti eva. Because these particles can't be seen. So how do you say that something existent is born of existence? Sadbuddhi anuvritta. So anuvritti avagata sattvanuvritti. Our argument is that at every stage that existence vritti, sadvritti, that is, it is, that isness, that existence persists. Seed is, sprout is, the plant is, the tree is, the fruit is, everywhere the isness persists. Let's go sadbuddhi. The idea of existence never goes away. The idea of existence persists at every stage. From a lump of gold and you make a rod, from that you make a wire, from that you make a... whatever you make all along, the isness always is there. That is the proof. Sadbuddhi, anuvritti, anugata, sattva anuvritti eva tatra pramanam. Sattva anuvritti, the persistence of sat, the persistence of existence or the isness is the very proof that existent entity comes from existence. Sadbuddhi, Bhashyakara says, sadbuddhi anuvritti he. Sattva anivrittischa iti sadvadinam satah eva sadutpattihi setsyate. Sadbuddhi anuvrittehe. The idea of sat is anuvritti, that persists at every stage. Therefore, sattva anivrittihi. So therefore, there is no nivritti. There is never a cessation of existence. The form changes. The name changes. The configuration changes. But that a thing is, that idea never goes at any stage. That the pot is, the clay is, the molecules are, the atoms are, the subatomic particles are, the God particle is, whatever. That isness never goes. So sattva anivrittihi, there never is a cessation of the idea of isness, idea of existence. Iti, because of that, sadvadinam sataha eva sadutpatti setsyati. Never sadvadinam, for those who accept sat as the fundamental principles, existence of the fundamental principles for us. Sataheva sadutpati setsyati. that a thing always comes out from an existent thing, from existence alone, existence comes, and not from non-existence. Says the Tikakara, Nanu Ananuvrittasyapi asataha karanatve kodoshaha. He says, just because non-existence does not persist, why should it not be the cause? Just an argument. All right, that existence persists at every stage, there is no cessation of existence. All right. So non-existence does not persist. But why? So why, still, why can it not be the cause? Just because non-existence does not permit, is that the reason for it not being cause? It can still be the cause. Nanu anuvrittasyapi asatah karanatve kodoshah. What's the defect here? What's the problem here? What's the fault here if it does not persist? Iti asankya anuvrittasyeva mridadehe karanatva darshanat. Mrut, etc. is what? So, for example, now he says, take the case of a pot. What is the cause of the pot? You say, clay is the material cause of the pot. How? On what basis do you say that clay is the material cause of this pot? Because clay is found in the pot. This is anuvritti. This is the continuity of clay in the pot. Therefore, you say that the clay is the material cause of the pot. You don't say that the thread is the cause of this pot. It is the cause of the cloth, all right. But nobody says that the thread is the cause of the pot because you do not find thread in the pot. Anuvrittasyeva vridadehe karanatva darshanat anuvrittasya tantvadehe ghatadi karanatva darshanat. Nobody says that this pot is made of gold. This is a clay pot. Nobody says a gold pot. See, if without persistence something can be called cause, if without being present in the pot, if something can be called the cause of the pot, then you can say gold is the cause of this pot. Because there is no need that it should persist. Then gold will be the cause of this pot. Or anything. No, it cannot be. The material cause must necessarily persist or continue in the effect. Ananuvrittasya tantvadehe ghatadikaranatva adarshanat. Ananuvritta means what? That means it does not persist. So tantu meaning a thread. Thread which does not persist in a part cannot be the cause of the part. So Vashyakara natu asadvadina. Vashyakara says natu asadvadina drishtantah asti asatah sadutpatteh. Natu asadvadinam drishtantah asti. The asadvadi is those who proclaim non-existence as the fundamental truth. They don't have an example. There is no experience, no illustration to prove that. Asatah sadutpatteh. Continuing the tika, asatah sadutpatti sambhavana hetu bhutah anuvrittasya karanatva sadako drishtanto nasti ityartha. So when can you prove that something is a material cause only when it persists? There is no example of a non-persistent material cause. Asatah sadutpati sambhavana hetu bhutah. When can you prove that something has come from non-existence? When you can prove that the cause need not persist in the effect, but that is not so. Anuvrittasya karanatva sadako drishtanto nasti. that there is no drishtanta, no illustration that can establish that a non-existent entity is the material cause, that non-existent thread is the cause of this part. Or in case of the cloth, a non-existent clay, which the clay does not exist here, that is the cause of this cloth, that is never found. And therefore, there is no example to prove that even if anything does not persist, that it can be the cause, there is no example. Anuvrittasya karanatvetu sahasti. Whether, however, anuvrittasya karanatve, that what persists in the effect is a material cause, for that all examples are there. Mrutiti bhashyakara says, mrutpindat ghatotpatti drishyate sadvadinam tadbhave bhavat tadbhave cha abhavat. Mrutpindat ghatotpatti drishyate. However, you see ghatotpatti, creation of part, you see from a lump of clay. So, we see the clay which is there in the lump persists in the pot also, then alone clay can be called the material cause. So, mrutpindat ghatotpatti drishyate sadvadinam. Sadvadinam of those who say that existent thing only comes from existent thing or existence, for them there are examples like the pot created from a lump of clay. Lump of clay is, and pot also is. Lump of clay is clay, and pot also is clay. So there is persistence of clay, and that is the example of creation of an existent entity from existence. Says the Tika, line 25 on the page 223, Syat etadevam yadi mrudaha karanatvam tadeva tu katham. Asking a fundamental question. How do you say that clay is the cause of the pot? How do you say? See, you are saying that for us the clay persists, therefore clay is the material cause of the pot. But how did you establish that clay is the cause of the pot? On what basis do you say that clay is the material cause of the pot? Then anvaya vyatireka darshayati. Bhashyakara shows it by anvaya vyatireka. Tadbhave, Bhashyakara said, tadbhave bhavat. So, tadbhave bhavat. When the clay is there, then the pot is there. Tadbhave cha bhavat. When the clay is not there, the pot is not there. Anvaya. Tadbhave bhavat. When the clay is there, pot is there. There is anvaya. Clay is not there, pot is not there. Vyatireka. So the anvaya vyatireka, the continuance and non-continuance establishes the cause-effect relationship. To establish the cause-effect, the material cause-effect relationship, anvaya vyatireka is the method by which Vashyakara shows how clay is the material cause of the pot. And it persists, meaning that the material cause must necessarily persist in the effect. Then Tikakara says, na kevalam asataha sadutpattu sadhaka bhava kintu badhakam apedi sadhaka and badhaka. Sadhaka, that which becomes a means of establishing something. Bhadaka, that in fact militates against that, which is, you know, which contradicts that. So not only there is no example to prove that an existent entity comes from non-existence, but in fact if there is a bhadaka, there is something that refutes that also. So Vashyakara says on page 223, यदि अभावादेव घटः उत्पद्येत घटार्थिना मृत्पिण्डः Namupadiyeta. See, if you say that part is created from non-existence, this is the word creating part, why should the part maker always reach out for the lump of clay? Yadi asabhavadeva gata utpadyeta. If the part is created from non-existence, then you do not require a substance such as clay. But here we find that the pot maker necessarily reaches out for clay in order for creating the pot. Ghatarthana mrutpindaha nu upadiyeta. Ghatarthi, one who is desirous of making a pot. Mrutpindaha nu upadiyeta. He would not reach out for mrutpinda, for the lump of clay. Bhadakantaram apyaha. This is another bhadaka. Another one that will refute, another one that will contradict your position. Abhava shabda iti, Vashyakara says. Abhava shabda buddhi anuvrittischa ghatadav prasajyeta. The cause persists in the effect. The cause is non-existence. Then, when you see the pot, what would be your idea? Pot is not will persist. If non-existence is the cause, and the cause persists in the effect, then everywhere there should be persistence of non-existence. So right now, when you look at the pot, then there is easiness. So the word is and the idea is are always associated with any object such as a pot, with anything that we experience. The idea of isness, the word is, the pot is, and that word is as a corresponding thought, corresponding idea. So word as well as idea of is always persist in everything. On the other hand, if non-existence was the cause, then what will you experience? Is not. This is not an elephant. This is not a book. This is not a table. That's how the ideas will be. Not. Abhava shabda buddhi anuvrittihi. Abhava shabda is not. And the buddhi, the corresponding thought that it is not. Ghatadu prasajyeta. So there will be prasanga, the occasion of this non-existence persisting in objects everywhere, such as pot and everything. Says the Tika, Ghata Adhikarye Murut Shabda Buddhyoho Anuvrutti Darshanadidhi Bhavaha. That in effect, such as the pot, there is all persistence of the word clay and the thought clay that persists in a product such as a pot. So Vashyakara says, Natu etadaste. But this is not so. We never find the cause not persisting in the effect. Therefore, asataha satkaranatva nirakaranam upasamharati. So from this discussion, it is established that how asat or non-existence cannot be the cause of an existent entity. That argument is concluded here. Ataha, it is Vashyakara says, ataha na asataha sadutpattihi. Atah, therefore, so this is conclusion, nigamanam. The conclusion, asat, therefore, na asatah sad utpattihi. The utpatti of sat or existent thing cannot be from non-existence, because drishtanta bhava, basically, there is no drishtanta. There is no experience. Understand, this is a very valid argument. If you cannot experience, then you cannot visualize in your mind. The thought in your mind depends upon your experience. Whatever you think always is based on some experience. Even if an imaginary thing is there which you have not experienced, In the dream you might find, for example, a dancing red elephant, suppose. You know, something impossible. In the dream you find a dancing red elephant. But there also the dance is experienced somewhere, the red is experienced somewhere, the elephant is experienced somewhere. So this person saw an elephant on the road, he saw also a woman with a red sari, and saw also a boy dancing. In dream you may combine all of them. Come with a ridiculous experience of a dancing red elephant. All right. But dance is there, red is there, elephant also is there. But you can never ever think of something that you have not experienced. You try. Try to think of it in your mind, something that you never experienced. Whatever thoughts occur in the mind are always based on something that we experienced. Whatever conclusions we draw in our life, the conclusions are all drawn from what we experienced. But nobody has ever experienced the creation of an existent thing from non-existence. Therefore, how do you arrive at that principle? It cannot be. Therefore, ataha na sataha sadutpatti iti. Still the argument continues. Every morning I see this fellow doing, you know, he's dancing. See from here every morning. Anuvruttasya karanatve. See, this is a very subtle discussion, but very important discussion. Because we don't pay attention to these things in our life. So, we are made to pay attention. How they have paid attention? You can see, in order to arrive at your conclusions, what attention you should pay. Don't arrive at conclusions just like that, you know. And so, we generally see superficial things and arrive at conclusions. Never go into depth of the things. That's the Indian mentality also. In engineering also, we are always told how to solve problems, that's all. And so, the fundamental principles were hardly paid attention. It's only when I went to the United States, that is when there is an emphasis on the fundamental things. That's how my interest in Vedanta was created. Because Vedanta is the most fundamental thing. I could say the Vedanta, in fact, gives us the understanding of what is most fundamental in life, so that you must know this. And that is what prompted me to go to Bombay to study the scriptures in detail, because Vedanta gives us an understanding of the fundamentals of life. That is what my interest was. That fundamental knowledge also does some other thing in your life, that I learned later. But from what was mine, what prompted me to study Vedanta is to understand the fundamentals of life. So we are discussing the fundamentals of life, which requires what kind of observation, what kind of perception is required. So now Vijnanavada, now comes the Now Shunyavadi is gone. Now Vijnanavadi comes. Who is Vijnanavadi? Vijnanavadi says that the only reality in life is nothing but thoughts. They do not accept any external world. They are called subjectivists. All there is subjective thing. Subjectivism means it is the imagination of mind. What is merely kalpana of the mind. Imagination of the mind. There is no part, understand. What is there is just the thought of the part. No, but I am experiencing what? That also is a thought. All there is, according to them, is a series of thoughts. That's all. And therefore, how do you establish a part? So says, anuvruttasya karanatve mrudghataha dushtanta uktaha na upadyate. So you are saying that what persists such as clay is the cause of an entity such as pot, even that also is not tenable. Iti vijnanavadi shankam anuvadati. That shanka or the doubt of the vijnanavadi. The vijnanavadi is the momentary consciousness or momentariness of everything. And what is consciousness? A thought. So momentary thought is the reality, that's all. That's the ultimate thing. Yadapi, Subhashyakara says, Yadapi ahuho mrutbuddhihi ghatamuddhihi nimittamiti mrutbuddhihi ghatamuddhihi karanam uchyate nato parmarthatah eva mruta ghatova astiti tadapi mrutbuddhihi vidyamana yaha eva ghatabuddhihi karanam iti na asatah sadutpattihi. Yadapi ahuhu, without mentioning, that the Vainashikas are mentioned, because the Upanishad specifically refutes that position. But here the Vashyakara refutes the other positions. So when you are in that process, you clarify all possible opposition or all possible doubts. Yadapi ahuhu. That some say, the Vijnanavadins say. So according to them, there is no entity such as a pot. What is that? Is pot thought, clay thought, ghatabuddhi, mrutbuddhi. Mrutbuddhi means what? The cognition of or thought of the mrut, thought of the pot. So imagine, what a philosophy. They dismiss the whole external world. They don't accept external objects at all. There is no such thing as an external object. All of these are taken up in the Mandukya Upanishad also, Mandukya Karika, in the Alata Shandi Prakranam. And there all of these are discussed. Here also it is mentioned that what you have is not mrut, what you have is not the clay, a lump of clay, what you have is a thought of the lump of clay. And what you have is not the pot, you have the thought of the pot. So they say that from the thought of clay, the thought of pot is created. Not from the clay, the pot is created. They don't accept the existence of these entities such as clay and pot. So what do they say? From the clay thought, the pot thought is created. So, mrut buddhihi ghata buddhihi nimittam. That clay thought creates the pot thought. Thank God, not the other way around, you know. At least there is some kind of a system there, a sequence. There is the clay thought that gives rise to the pot thought. Not clay giving rise to pot, understand? Clay thought giving rise to pot thought. Iti. Mrut buddhihi ghata buddhihi karanam uchyate. Says, you fellows call the clay the cause of the pot, only because the clay thought comes first and then the pot thought comes. And so, at the most you can say that the clay thought is the cause of the pot thought and not the clay the cause of pot. Understand this? There is no entity such as clay or a pot. So the clay thought is the cause of the pot thought at the most. So mrut buddhihi ghata buddhihi karanam uchyate. So nimittam eti anvaya vidarekavat. Nimittam. That is, the clay thought is not there, pot thought is not there, clay thought is there, pot thought is there. That way, clay thought can be called the nimittam, the cause for the pot thought. Natu paramartha deva. So mrut and ghata are the two words. तदु परमासतैव मृत घटो वा अस्ति इति. द विज्ञानवादी सेज इन रियलिटी देयर इज नो सच थिंग एज अ मृत, अ क्ले और एन एंटिटी कॉल्ड पॉट. इन रियलिटी दे आर नॉट देयर. ऑल देयर इज क्ले थॉट एंड पॉट थॉट. क्ले थॉट गिविंग राइज टू पॉट थॉट. ओनली इन दैट सेंस यू कैन से दैट द क्ले थॉट इज द कॉज ऑफ द पॉट थॉट, नॉट द क्ले द कॉज ऑफ द पॉट. डिफरेंस हियर. So, Tikakar is a Nivetrati Purovarti. Mrut Buddhi, Ghata Buddhi, Nivetam, meaning what? Mrut Buddhi is Ghata Buddhi Purovarti. That is precedes the pot thought. Iti. Says the Tika, Yadyapi Pratyakshadi Pramana Siddhasya Bahya Padarthasya न अभाव है. हाउ डू यू से दैट इट इज नॉट देयर? हाउ डू यू से द एक्सटर्नल वर्ल्ड इज नॉट देयर? बाह्य पदार्थस्य प्रत्यक्षादि प्रमाण सिद्धस्य वी परसीव देम. एंड व्हाट यू परसीव यू कांट से इट इज नॉट देयर. नो नो, यू आर नॉट परसीव, यू आर इमेजिनिंग. हाउ कैन यू से दैट? सो यद्यपि प्रत्यक्षादि Pramana Siddha, Vedantins accept also the Vyavaharika Satta. Therefore, three degrees of reality are accepted: Pratibhasika Satta, Vyavaharika Satta, and Paramatika Satta. What is Pratibhasika Satta? The rope snake. So you are imagining something which is not there. Merely thought, a Brahma. Vyavaharika Satta, a rope is the Vyavaharika Satta. It is equally available for everybody's perception. And Paramadhika Satta, Asti Bhati Premisi, Paramadhika Satta, which cannot be negated at all. So, Yadyapi Pratyakshadi Pramana Siddhasya Bahya Padarthasya Na Abhava Upalabdhe. Upalabdhe means perception. Because you perceive, therefore, you cannot say that the external objects do not exist. Even though that is your principle, you don't accept that principle. Therefore, the nirakarana anukuleva dvadvishtanta. So, really speaking, our example of clay and pot refutes your principle that there is no external object. Because we take the clay and we make pot out of that. You can't say clay is not there and pot also is not there. All your activities, all nothing but thought. You can say whatever you want to say. But then, that is just a saying. So in fact, even the example of clay and pot also refutes the idea of the principle that there is no external thing. But, abhyupagamevi tvatpakshe, alright. Suppose we accept your position, that there is no external object, all there is are the thoughts of the object. Suppose we accept that, then also. Tvatpakshe na dushtanta haiti. Still, you don't have an example of existence coming from non-existence. So Vashyakara said, Tadapi mrut buddhi vidyamana vidyamana eva ghata buddhi karanam. Even if you say that mrut buddhi, the clay thought, is the cause of the pot thought, but you would accept this much, that existing clay thought is the cause of the existing pot thought, not a non-existing clay thought. An existing clay thought is the cause of the existing pot thought. So, tadapi vidyamana mrut buddhi. The existing clay thought, vidyamanayaha ghata buddhi karanam, is the cause of the existent pot thought. So, even though we don't accept your position, but even if you accept your position, then also it does not prove the creation of existence from non-existence. From an existing pot thought, the existent clay thought comes. A clay thought, existent pot thought comes. Iti na sataha sadutpatti. Therefore, that also does not become an example of the creation of existence from the non-existence. will continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Atmeri Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri